Windows Movie Maker 2012 is a free program that comes with your Windows computer. It is a popular application for video editing, as well as creating digital stories with photos and videos. In this tutorial, we will learn how to use Movie Maker to create digital stories. Before we start, please make sure you have the latest version of Movie Maker installed in your computer. We will be using Windows Movie Maker 2012 in this tutorial. Visit the following link to download the latest version of Movie Maker. Once you're ready, you may start Movie Maker by going to the Start menu on your PC. The Movie Maker interface is divided into three areas: Timeline, also called Storyboard, on the right, Preview Window on the left, and the ribbon containing commands for editing your video at the top. Before you start creating a video in Movie Maker, the first thing you need to do is to import or add some pictures and videos to the Movie Maker. In order to import your media, click on Add Videos and Photos icon under the Home tab. We will add several pictures as well as video clips in this example. Select the pictures you would like to add to the storyboard by either one at a time and click Open, or use your Control key to do multiple selection and add the desired pictures to your timeline. Notice that Movie Maker is able to accept a variety of photo and video formats. To see a list of accepted video and photo formats, check out the list next to the file name. Once inserted into the storyboard, pictures, videos, and sound clips can be removed by hitting the Delete key on your keyboard. Alternatively, you can also do right-click on a selected image and hit Remove. You may also move or change the order of storyboard elements by simple drag-and-drop action. You can always undo or redo your changes by using the controls in the Quick Access toolbar. You may also use Ctrl plus Z for undo and Ctrl plus Y for redo on your keyboard. In Movie Maker, you are able to change the size of your storyboard items by using the thumbnail size and zoom in controls at the lower right of the screen. Increase the size of the thumbnails if you need to see more details about your storyboard objects. You may also play with zooming controls to get the desired view of your timeline. When you hover over an object in the storyboard, you will see a pop-up window displaying information such as name of the object, applied effects, and the duration. Also, notice that some pictures may come with automatic captions. If you don't want these captions to appear in your video, just select and hit the Delete key on your keyboard to remove them. Let's review editing options for pictures in Movie Maker. When you mouse over pictures in your timeline, you will see their durations are set to 7 seconds. All pictures are displayed for 7 seconds by default in Movie Maker unless you change it. You may always change the duration of a picture in the storyboard by going to the Video Tools tab. This tab gets activated once you click on a picture or video, as it is one of the contextual tabs. These tabs appear at the top of the ribbon depending on the object you have selected. They allow you to edit selected object. So if you click on a picture or video in your storyboard, you would have video toolbar appear. And if you click on a sound, a music tool tab would appear. And if you click on a text or caption, a text tool tab would appear at the top of the menu. To change the duration, select the picture and click the Edit menu. Lowering the default 7 seconds for duration would allow your image to display shorter or faster in the video. And increasing the duration seconds would make your picture to display longer or slower in the video. Now let's review our video clip closer by selecting it in the storyboard. We can tell that this video clip is about 15 seconds long, and there are no effects on it. We also know that it plays with speed 1, in other words, in its original recording speed. You may change the speed of a video by going to the Edit tab under Video Tools. Find the Speed drop-down menu and select the desired speed. 2x means twice as fast, 0.5x will mean twice as slow. Similar to duration in pictures, you can trim a video from beginning or end of it. To trim, you will need to click on the Trim tool. By adjusting the handles in the preview window, you may trim your video. You can also set your start point and end point by selecting from the drop-down menu. Once you're done, just click Save Trim button. Another video editing option is the ability to split a video into several parts. In order to split, move your playhead to the desired location in Storyboard, right-click and hit Split, or choose Split option under Video Tools. Now my video is divided into two separate parts. In addition to adding pictures and video clips, we will also demonstrate adding some sound clips or background music to our storyboard. In order to add a sound clip or background music, click Add Music icon under the Home tab. You will see two options for adding music. The first one is adding a sound file locally from your PC. And the second option is adding the music from an online source. Let's click Add Music from PC first. To see accepted formats, click the list next to the file name. When you add sound clips, they will be inserted to the point where your playhead is positioned in your timeline or storyboard. You may also change the position of your sound clip in the storyboard by simple drag and drop action. Alternatively, you may manually adjust the start time under Music Tools. You may also add music from online sources. These services allow you to buy music or download copyright-free sounds. For example, Free Music Archive has a variety of copyright-free music, which you can use in your digital story. On the other hand, if you're looking for free sound clips, you may also check out Audio Micro website. This website has an extensive free sound effects section. Similar to trimming a video in Movie Maker, you can trim sound clips or music by changing your sound clip's start and end point under the Music Tools. Another editing option for your sound clip is splitting. Just like splitting a video clip, move your playhead to the desired location in Storyboard for your sound. Right-click and hit Split. Or choose Split under Music Tools. Unlike the previous versions, in Movie Maker 2012, there is a built-in method for doing voiceovers or recording narrations. That's why we strongly recommend upgrading your Movie Maker to the latest version by visiting the following link. Before recording a narration, make sure you have a microphone plugged in or use your computer's built-in microphone. In order to record narration, first select a point where you would like to insert your narration in your storyboard and then click on the Record Narration button under the Home tab. Click the Record button to start recording, and use the Stop button to finish recording. Let's demonstrate a recording. Happy birthday, baby panda! When you stop your recording, Movie Maker would like to save your file. Select a location in your computer, and then hit Save. Notice that my narration is inserted into the timeline and represented with a brown bar below my music. Once your recording or narration is inserted into the timeline, you can always move it by drag and drop action within the storyboard. If you are using a previous version of Movie Maker, you may not have this built-in recording tool. As a workaround to this problem, you can always pre-record your narration in another software and import that as a sound clip to your storyboard. In Movie Maker 2012, you may have several audio included in your video project. For example, in our example, we have a background music which is represented by green, a narration represented by a light brown color, and finally, a sound coming from the video clip in my storyboard. Consider these audio elements working independently as if they have their own track. In other words, they can be stacked over each other. So overlapping is not an issue with different kinds of audio. However, when you have the same type of audio, overlapping becomes a problem. For example, you can play both your background music and your narration at the same time, since they are considered separate audio objects, as in this example. Happy birthday, baby panda! They won't cancel out each other and they will play together when they overlap. Or, you can play your background music, narration, and video music all at the same time, and it won't be a problem in Movie Maker. However, if you would like to insert, let's say, another background music into your timeline, if you already have a background music in your storyboard, they will have to share the space dedicated to that kind in storyboard. This sometimes causes sound clips bumping into each other. Now let's demonstrate this problem. Let's add another music or sound clip to the middle of my background music, represented by green here. Notice that the new sound clip starts after this point and removes the second half of the background music, as they are not capable of overlapping in the same audio track. So there's no way to place them on top of each other. They can only be inserted into the timeline, back to back, one at a time. Another issue with working with several audio in your storyboard is adjusting the volume of these audio objects. You need to be careful with adjusting the volume, as all of the sound files would play at the same time if they overlap. So let's say the narration audio is more important to you in your project. Then you would need to make sure it would be more prominent in the video. In order to do this, you need to increase the volume of your narration and lower the volume of your other audio elements in your project. Click on your narration and locate the Narration Tools tab at the top. To increase the volume, find Narration Volume icon and increase the volume by adjusting the volume handle. In order to lower other audio elements in this video, select your music and then click on the Music Tools to lower the overall volume of this music track. You may do the same for your video. Click on the video and then click Video Tools. Lower the video volume. So depending on the need, make sure you will be adjusting the volume of your audio elements for better sound quality in your video.